Here we are on the Las Vegas Strip. I haven't driven this thing on the Strip yet. We'll see how this wide behemoth does in Vegas traffic. Really, it's more how am I going to do driving this car in Vegas traffic, but yep, should be fun. Also, I kind of wanted to do a efficiency test as well, I guess you can call it. I just wanted to see how well this thing does, you know, when I'm not driving this truck like an absolute demon. Because yes, this truck is extremely fun. I find myself, I have a lead foot sometimes. I like to floor it. Especially when you have a truck that goes, you know, 0-60 in 4.1 seconds. You almost kind of have to. Of course, the Vegas Strip is empty. That's a first. Usually on Fridays, it's pretty packed, but so it is a beautiful day in Vegas, so I figure I would just take it down. I'm going to my favorite spot, my supercharging spot at the Link. We'll see if they actually fixed some of the destination chargers they had down there, because a lot of them were broken. Like, you know, they've been broken for over 6 months, but I did, you know, contact Tesla, and Tesla said that they would get touch base maybe with the Link to get them fixed, so fingers crossed. Fingers crossed, folks. Get a green light someday. And also, I'm still debating whether I should just speed these parts along where I'm at a red light, or if I should just keep them. I'm probably just going to keep them, because why not? And also, as you can see, I did get rid of my rearview mirror. Yes, it's gone, because I don't need it. It's probably the most worthless feature in this vehicle. Like, yes, I know Tesla has to ship them with rear view mirrors, but they do make them very easy to remove. And they have even a little cover that you can pop in there as well. So Tesla knew what they were doing. They knew what they were doing. They knew people were going to remove their rear view mirrors. Yeah, man, empty at the Strip. I love this. Of course, there's a lot of foot traffic, which, you know, I expect, but usually there's a lot of cars, especially considering it's Friday. I'm very surprised. I'm guessing a lot of people will arrive tonight, and it will be just packed tonight. We're kind of already almost there. I was expecting a much longer video. I was thinking when I started recording, like, oh, this is probably going to be like a really long 30-minute video, because it's going to take me forever to navigate through the Strip in Vegas traffic, but nope, doesn't seem like it, so it'll be a short one for y'all today. There we go. Yes, for those of you that have watched my FSD videos and all that before, you'll know that this is my favorite spot. Just because it's such a prime location, especially if you're looking to supercharge your vehicle, which, you know, soon we won't be seeing just Teslas. We'll be seeing Fords and Rivians and everything. So I'm really looking forward to that. It might be a little congested, but, you know, Tesla's working their butts off to install superchargers. I think they install a supercharger station like every minute of the year. Like, if you break it down, like every minute or every hour, I don't remember what, but it's pretty impressive for how quick they install superchargers. They definitely have a almost a monopoly in terms of, especially efficiency, of how they install superchargers and cost. I'm still no autopilot just yet. Still have to drive by hand, but that's okay, because this thing is fun to drive. I can't you know, say that enough times. This truck is fun. I enjoy driving. It's one of those like I'm looking forward to getting to my truck and driving. Until I get down to the Strip. Because normally the Strip is pretty stressful in terms of driving, because it's pretty brutal. It can get pretty packed, but I'm definitely glad there's nobody here today. So I'm definitely digging the side view cameras, especially like when you turn on the turn signal. So one kind of downfall of the Cybertruck, just the fact that I can't see the nose of this truck. The truck of or like the nose of this thing is huge, and really the only way to see, like thank God for a front view camera, which, so there's the rear view camera and here's the front view camera. Like, thank God for that. Even though like the, it's like a fishing, I can't talk today. I'm sorry, everyone, but this is like a wide angle lens, a fisheye lens. So the depth perception is definitely off compared to at least what I'm seeing, but I guess it's better than nothing, but I just normally stick with this view. Like I said, you got your efficiency and all that there. You have our camera, and then of course you have this beautiful map as well, which, you know, it's very, very responsive. Tesla definitely nailed their software in terms of like the screen, because normally I've seen some where it's like extremely laggy and extremely clunky, but I call it basically just an iPad in your vehicle. There's really no other way to compare it. That comes up, just kind of, it's a little extra additional safety feature just to show, like, hey, someone's next to you, you should probably not get into that lane. Which I'm all for. We'll end that trip since I kind of know where I'm going. Yeah, I always go to just this, yep, this one here. And for those of you that are watching, maybe you've never been to this supercharger, but it's gated. And there's a trick to get in there. All you just do is you click on the supercharger itself, it gives you the code 5693 pound. And we're good to go. See just how busy the supercharger is. I think they said there was like 15 slots. Yeah, it's not very busy today. I'm kind of pleased. Yep, got our code here, and it's nice and gated. Like I said, I like parking here just because, one, I know my vehicle is going to be safe, because there's always other Teslas here. So I know, like, no one's gonna mess with my car, but I'm just gonna put in the gate code. Wait for our little ticket. And yes, you do have to pay to park here, but I do have a Caesars Platinum card for being military, so I do get parking, you know, for free and all that. So definitely a huge advantage of coming here. That's the main reason I come here, because, like I say, if you've parked in Vegas before, you know it is not cheap. But yeah, nice, nobody's here. Problems finding a destination charger that actually works. I know one of these actually works, but I'm not really sure which one. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Now it's a short video, but yeah, I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give it that old thumbs up. If you're new, haven't subscribed, you'll know what to do. But yeah, hope you enjoy the rest of your day.